guest today for you on the Daily Edition, Shane Warne's high price tag. How much the cricketer demands for TV appearances, it's revealed in the new No Spin memoir.
Plus, Markle family showdown. Meghan's sister is in London and she wants to see the Duchess, but will they meet face to face?
And Bindi Irwin's greatest fear, how she feels about the animal that took her dad, Steve Irwin's life.
Then they're Australia's fabulous foursome. What happens when one member of human nature breaks out for a side project? Hear the result as Andrew Tierney performs soon. Time now to get the very latest from the 7 newsroom. Thanks, Ryan.
Tom, Sally, good to be with you both. Good afternoon, everyone. A man is in custody after two men were fatally stabbed in North Queensland. The small community of Eyre is in shock after their bodies were found in the street. Officers performed CPR but could not save them. Ben Downey reports.
Police arrived at the bloody Topton Street crime scene shortly after midnight after a witness called 000. There they found a 27 and 37-year-old man bleeding out on the street from knife wounds. This morning, forensic investigators were combing the scene for clues, hoping to gain an insight in the grim chain of events that led to the deaths of the men.
It's a horrific scene to arrive there and find two people. You're talking about the dead of night where it's totally dark.
Officers spoke with neighbours and holidayers. None heard anything of the events that took place just metres away.
Quite often there's parties and people together and, yeah. No, it's usually a good place down here.
Neighbours described the owner as a quiet man who kept to himself.
Nice, didn't really know him much. Really shocking too, it's only a small little place.
Forensics are at a very early stage and officers are now undertaking what will be an extensive investigation. Officers have arrested a 19-year-old man who sustained a leg injury and a 29-year-old woman is recovering in Townsville Hospital with a shoulder wound. Police are treating the deaths as suspicious and haven't ruled out a murder charge.
Ben Downey reporting there. Authorities are struggling to reach remote communities cut off by the earthquake and tsunami that's hit Sulawesi in Indonesia. Mass graves are being dug as shattered survivors search desperately for missing loved ones. More than 830 people have been killed in the disaster, but that number is expected to rise.
The devastation is vast. Rubble, twisted cars and debris. And in the scramble to find survivors, rescuers are using their hands to search because there isn't enough heavy equipment. It's unclear how many people are trapped or were pulled out to sea, but the number of dead here is surging. The walls started falling around us, says this woman, who escaped a shopping mall before it collapsed. The injured are being evacuated by military plane as disaster officials here struggle to cope. The destruction on the coast in Palu is only part of it. Areas closer to the quake's epicenter are still cut off. What has happened to over a quarter million people there, unknown.
The bridges and the roads are damaged to get in. It's very, very difficult.
The island was struck by two powerful disasters. Though the tsunami took experts by surprise.
It's unusual for an earthquake which generates a tsunami to be so close to land, so the shaking destroys towns and buildings. It was a double whammy.
With more than 200 aftershocks recorded so far, thousands are sleeping outside. Disease is a growing worry. Food, fuel, fresh water in short supply, and looters are stealing whatever's left.
Aid has been slow to reach the area because only part of the airport at Palu is open. It's an 18-hour drive from here and parts of the road are blocked. Officials warn that as they're able to push into those remote areas, the death toll is going to spike.
A driver was lucky to escape with minor injuries after a dramatic ute crash in Brisbane. The vehicle smashed into a shop front, causing an awning collapse before careering off the road and through a fence. Ben Murphy reports.
Good morning. It's been a narrow escape for a 26-year-old driver who lost control of his ute while coming along Lutwyche Road around midnight last night. There's been quite a large clean-up operation, but you can see some of the aftermath still visible. The ute slammed into this shop front, taking out two supporting beams, which caused the awning to collapse. Along here is where the ute continued. You can see street signs have come down. He's smashed into the fence and trees. And if you look this way, you'll see a very large shatter mark there on the bus shelter. That's where one of the beams has actually catapulted from the store straight into. So you can only imagine what may have happened. Had anyone been there waiting for a bus, this could have had a truly awful ending. Now, the driver, a 26-year-old, has been transported to hospital in a stable condition. He only sustained minor injuries as a result, which is rather remarkable. Police are still investigating what has caused this crash. No charges have yet been laid, though the driver's license has been temporarily suspended as officers await the result of drug tests.
Ben Murphy with that report. Well, celebrations are in full swing for the Roosters after their victory over the Storm in the NRL Grand Final. A sea of red, white and blue supporters greeted the Premiership winning team at Allianz Stadium this morning, and players made their way through a tunnel of adoring fans before being presented on stage. All eyes once again were on Cooper Cronk after his grand final heroics, playing with a broken bone in his shoulder.
Spirited effort from you last night, mate.
Yeah, everyone from the top down to the football club, admin staff, playing group, fans and supporters sacrificed a lot for me to come here, so it's just my duty to go out and give my absolute best.
Today's celebrations followed on from last night, with streets closed off around East Leagues Club in Bondi Junction for an all-night party. Doesn't happen too often in grand finals in any way, shape or form, but that was such a dominant performance, you could not take anything away from the Roosters. They were clearly the better team in that game.
Excellent game.
Yeah.
Good one. Still to come this afternoon, why Sharon Osbourne is saying goodbye to one of TV's most coveted gigs. Plus, E is for Eugenie. The princess has revealed her commemorative royal wedding china. But there's one major problem. We're going to have the details soon.
But next, controversial Kanye West, why the rapper's pro-Trump rant has celebrities up in arms.